The American soil is full of the corpses of my ancestors. Why is my freedom or my citizenship or my right to live there? How is it conceivably a question now? It comes as a great shock around the age of 5 or 6 or 7 to discover that the flag which you have pledged allegiance along with everybody else has not pledged allegiance to you.
As I open my eyes, I look outside and all I see is violence, pain, suffering, and misery. Plus a couple friends, maybe 2 or 3 to keep it company. I prefer black coffee, you like a cup of tea. What's wrong with being different, you and I? We differ in many ways, but skin color draws the line that divides. Who decides black or white at birth? The only time we get to choose that is when applying for work. But make no mistakes, God makes no mistakes. He made me this way, but he made you the same. With one vision, to give him all the glory. One mission, love each other as he first loved us. No division, that's no religion, just pure love and nothing else. It's caring for the world and wanting nothing for yourself. Standing up for what's right, saying I can lead. Apparently, it's not enough to say that I can't breathe. So get your knee off the back of my neck, the back of that bus we reject. No, we don't need your pity, just respect. What happened to give me liberty or give me death? Now it's just take my liberty and take my breath. Keep us in check so we can't progress. Cops take 2 shots if we take 1 step, but I'm not resisting, quite the opposite. We just hate the opposition and our position, and our women are forced to raise their children alone in broken homes and poor conditions with the fathers missing. But it gets even harder, afraid their sons and daughters in the streets could get slaughtered by the ones who swore to serve and protect. I guess that oath don't mean much these days. Shit, either that or black lives matter, much less these days. Either way, we gotta come together and rise above it. Hard times don't last, we'll overcome it. And to all our white brothers and sisters that stood with us through the struggles, we appreciate your efforts and we love you. But for now, let's just try to imitate the one above us and love each other. That's the recipe for peace. Peace.
And the main thing for us to remember is that the same crime element that white people are scared of, black people are scared of. What is that? We need protection too. If I can't live free, if I can't live with the same respect as the next man, I don't want to be here. Because God has cursed me to see what life should be like. If God wanted me to be this person and be happy here, he wouldn't let me feel so oppressed. He wouldn't let me feel so trampled on. I'm not saying I'm going to rule the world or I'm going to change the world, but I guarantee that I will spark the brain that will change the world. And that's our job, is to spark somebody else watching us. We might not be the ones, but let's not be selfish. And because we're not going to change the world, let's not talk about how we should change it. I don't know how to change it, but I know if I keep talking about how dirty it is out here, somebody's going to clean it up.